I'm Dr. Mitesh Shetty, Head of Department and Consultant, Department of Medical Genetics, Manipal Hospital. This department is 22 years old in Manipal Hospital. We are having in-house facility of counseling as well as a high-end genetic laboratory. Most cancers are idiopathic, so that is not a hereditary, but small portion of cancer is familial. Breast cancer is the second common cause of cancer. In every woman, they have a risk of developing a breast cancer around 12% sometime in their life. Hereditary breast and ovarian cancer syndrome is a genetic condition where there's increased risk for breast cancer in males and females, ovarian cancer, pancreatic cancer, and certain other cancers like prostate and skin cancer like melanoma. There are two genes there which is known as BRCA1 and BRCA2. More than these two genes, there are other 22 genes are there which is associated with hereditary breast and ovarian cancer, which we call as HBOC. Only 5 to 10% of breast cancers are hereditary cancers. When a person has this cancer, then it has a 50% chance of passing it to next generation. Now again, cancer, the genetic is a little different. So once the individual person carries this mutation, doesn't mean that person will develop a cancer. It just says that the chance of developing a cancer is more than the population. So now we have a treatment which is immunotherapy. If they are positive for BRCA1 and BRCA2, they have a different immunotherapy. So earlier, the cancer, this test was only for the at-risk people, but as the genetic is evolving, it has a benefit to the patient also. In cancer, we have to always test the affected individual. In the cancer, we use the technology which is called as next-gen sequencing, which is called as NGS, where we sequence multiple genes together. So as I told you, there are 24 genes associated with HBOC. We can sequence the multiple genes together and we can see those variants, whether those are present in the individual or not. Another thing which is important in cancer is counseling. Counseling is very important. What is the patient is going to benefit and what is the at-risk people are going to benefit, and not that we can say directly test the unaffected individual. So counseling is very important. We are in an era where we are moving towards precision medicine. Right now what we are giving treatment is one size which fits all. But in precision medicine, the medicine which is designed specific for the genetic changes, the lifestyle and the environment factor, it will give the maximum benefit. So the precision medicine is nothing but the right medicine for the right person at right dosage at right time. In Manipal Hospital, we have next-gen sequencing and we have a counseling facility. Along with our cancer team, it helps in the better patient care.